Welcome to Four Comics on Three Tables.
As good a name as any. Yes.
Hello and welcome to Four Comics on Three Tables.
Oh, I like to call it Four Guys, Three Cups.
Oh. It is for this joke that we have brought Rohan Joshi here.
Done.
You know Anirban Das Gupta and you know Sourav Ghosh.
Four
and
comics, four mobiles.
We are killing it at this naming thing. But apart from our talents in naming things, literally, we are also here to promote some stuff. Because हम भी फिल्म स्टार मोड में आ गए हैं. हम भी प्रमोशन कर ये हमारा कपिल शर्मा बेसिकली आज आया हम लोग खुद ही
और तुम दोनों लोगों का शो है और हमारा कॉमेडी का बजट इतना लो होता है कि हमारे कपिल शर्मा पे दो शो एक साथ प्रमोट होता है क्योंकि इंडिविजुअल एपिसोड ये कपिल शर्मा का भी नहीं होता है. लाइक आधा तानाजी प्रमोट होता है और फिर लगा के रणवीर से होता है ये हट अभी मेरा
मैं बोल ही नहीं
सकता. नहीं
नहीं ये एकदम मैक्स लो बजट. The two things that are being promoted and we'll discuss more than the shows, of course.
Yes.
Afsos, a dark comedy thriller that is out on Amazon Prime Video.
And Life is Good, stand-up special by Ashish, Shakya. That's
it. I just want to point it out that when you said Afsos,
yeah,
you pointed towards him.
No, I did both.
You should be doing this.
He didn't let me finish. I was going to say Anirban Das Gupta and Sourav Ghosh.
It's fine. When I say that Life is Good is coming out, I'll point towards him.
second stand-up special.
Well, his life is good because he's not going to be sitting around checking comments.
Mera ek minute pehle ho gaya. Mera exam do log pehle khatam ho gaya. Basically, ye ho raha
hai. I think you should give us tips on how we should
mention that. Ashish's special is also coming out,
yes,
which is Life is Good.
It's already out.
It's already out.
Thematically, at least, sounds completely opposite of Afsos, right?
Yes.
So is this like a positive special?
Yes, broadly speaking, it is a positive special. But at this point, if you've seen it or you might have heard about it, there are bits where I get intensely personal and a little bit of darkness, ennui, whatever you want to call it.
Right.
Just existentialism has crept in. Yeah. I've tried to make it as funny and as honest as possible.
Yeah.
But it has crept in.
Basically, what you're saying is, after knowing you for 15 years, what you're saying is that somewhere in the middle of the special, he forgot to perform and was just himself for 10 minutes.
And the camera kept rolling.
This air of despondency. But doctor, I am Pagliacci.
Yes.
followed by a great dick joke.
That was essentially a template. Truth, fart and dick.
I feel like that's 90% of how comedians process emotions. It's like we say things that are raw and then we're like, oh shit, like, actually, main ye kaise bol sakta hu?
Essentially.
All comics process emotions.
Because the bit essentially talks about, hey, life is good, but you know what? I think maine bahut jeela. It's okay if I die. That's the general gist of it.
Okay.
And that's where I think the connect is interesting because we got talking, Anirban and I.
Yeah.
Like, you know, there's something here. We can definitely jam on this.
Yes.
Because your character, I love the line in the trailer itself, where Gulshan Devaiah's character says ki meri life ki story itni kharab hai ki
मुझे लगता है उन्होंने खुद लिखी है.
And I was like, this is such a writer thing to say. That was a great line. So tell me first, how did this, like, why is this idea your mainstay? This guy wants to kill himself.
This character is very close to our lives also. Like, because I remember when we were thinking about this like 3-4 years back and we were looking for other people to write this show with, I used to go on Twitter and see who is putting out tweets at 3 in the morning and like really depressed thoughts. You know, like Hussein Hydri is one. That's why I approached him. Hey, you come here. you write with us. So I like, I connected. Like, we connected with you know, that doom and gloom that you face every night and wanted to make something out of it. And one core thought was that in movies we see that, you know, okay, a hero can start off as a loser, but in the end becomes a winner.
Right.
And we were like, no. If he's a loser, he'll remain a loser.
Spoiler alert.
That's
man.
A spoiler, dude.
No, it's not a spoiler. There's enough. Is it?
Yeah.
So when writing this, like, your starting point was immortality. Do you then relate to Gulshan's character, Nakul? Do you relate to...
Yeah, like, definitely. Like, I... that was my main, like, point of interest. That this is, like, a character that we can, like, write keeping, like, so, like, when we were writing, we used to, like, incorporate things that, like, that's happening to us into the show directly. Like, I went to therapy, and then suddenly next day, there's a therapist character in the show.
It's funny how that happens.
And then, like, you know, all the insights I have, which I can't discuss in therapy, I'm like, let's do it in the movie. But I can't do it in the movie, let's do it in therapy. So.
And this happened on a scene-to-scene basis, not just the, like, overall arc, like, I remember once we were just crossing the road and we were already in the process of writing the show, and then suddenly we felt like, you know, it wouldn't be interesting if somebody, the suicidal man, tries to cross the road with his eyes shut, like he blindfolds himself and does it. And then while in bit, like, we are crossing the road on the divider, we're discussing this, and the cars are zooming past us.
We're
like, oh fuck, this should be in the show. And then we're, you know, going against me logistically. Bahut hi show
hai. This is this one. Jab bagali aadmi art karta hai na, ekdam. You could have hit it.
Yaar, Ashish, yaar. That also in existential baat karke life death karke tu bagali le aaya. This is the ad of his show.
See, it was deep joke. It was essentially that. But so then, do you then, because you obviously, you relate to the character a little bit.
Yeah, there's this one line in the first episode when Nakul talks about how he deals with the problems in his life. He said that bachpan mein jab din kharab jata tha, to main jaldi se so jata tha, taki din hi khatam ho jaye. The next day is a new day, so like it's a new start. Aur mujhe abhi zindagi ke sath bhi yahi karna.
I have an actual friend who uses this philosophy.
Yeah, and I use this philosophy.
Yeah, yeah. I have an actual friend in when we were at AC Jagenga Master. I had this friend who, if the problem got too intense, he's like, you know what, I'm just gonna go pass out for a bit. Because anyway, whatever happening right now, I can't deal with it.
Yes.
Okay. If I fuck off for 4 hours and pass out, I'll A, wake up energized. B, either the problem will have escalated to a degree where I have no choice but to confront it, or it will have passed.
Yes.
I can't do anything at this moment. Peace out, boom. Literally, that's what he used to do.
I do that generally. Like, if somebody asks me to post on Instagram and I don't know what to post, some like hashtag campaign and all, I'm like, let's do it tomorrow, okay? Like, let me now sleep. Tomorrow, some idea will come and the sun is out.
Just restart. Lock screen and this.
Yeah.
But do you relate to the character?
Not just this character. It's throughout all the entire show, all the characters. There are certain things which I have said, which somehow I am embarrassed to say in person. Like, I can't do it on stand-up. Like, there are some deep secrets which I wouldn't even tell which places those are.
Yeah, yeah.
But those are like very true.
Personal
like,
stuff.
Personal stuff. Which comes out, maybe it comes out in a line only, but I'm too hurt to tell it to a larger audience.
Right.
It's easy to essentially remove it one layer from yourself.
Yeah, from yourself and let the character
say.
My friend.
Yeah, yeah.
But then my friend was depressed the other day.
Bring it 200 people to like, you know.
And it's none of the suicidal stuff. No, that's all him, okay.
At this point, we would like to point out that both shows, neither show encourages suicide.
Yes.
I was a little bit.
It goes into territory, but it's overall positive. You also have a show called Death Jokes.
Yeah.
And I've not seen it. I've heard very good things about it. But is that personal? Do you create distance there? What is that show like? Wo kaisa hai?
And what are the jokes on the show about?
Dude, the poster, have you seen?
The poster
I'm dikha sakte ispe, but poster is basically him just lying there and naak mein rui hai and mala hai, and that's
very good. He's actually lying on a, like,
that's,
you know,
amazing. That's
very also cheesy. No, but I've always been very interested with the concept of death, and I want to know what's on the other side, you know? Like, I just want to...
Do you think there's something on the other side?
That's what I want to know. Like, I want to be immortal, but I just want to die once.
Right.
Just see what happens.
Right.
Or then trial ball. But I obviously this can't happen unless you die. And that, I guess, is the only pro of dying. So that you get to see that other story. So I just was thinking about that. You know, what is on the other side?
Right.
And I've been trying to explore that. But as you said, that it's not very easy to make these things funny.
Right, right.
Yeah.
So ultimately, wo bhi watered down ho gaya. It's not exactly what I want to explore, but at least in this show, in my special, I try to go towards that direction.
That's, so this is you a one-hour show, right?
Yeah, probably. Ultimately I come down to Om Puri's death. Okay? I do 8 minutes on Om Puri's death. So, but what I want to talk about is...
So oddly so specific.
Om Puri is the only person who tweets after death.
Yeah.
That's his thing.
That's my, that's the, what yeah. my bit is about.
Yeah. Amazing.
He, yeah. like, he's still active.
He's still active?
Yes. He's alive oh, on really? Social media, is what I'm saying.
Oh, really?
That's yeah, awesome. He wishes Nazirudin Shah birthday. So, yeah, I mean, that's where...
we live in surreal, surreal times. Yeah.
But
all kya things are also? Like, in that special, oddly, I talk about suicide also a lot. And like how, you know, we all have suicidal thoughts, even if it's for fleeting moment.
Everyone's been to a terrace once in their life.
It's called something, dude.
It's as simple as that.
It's called Call of the Void, apparently.
Every single human that's ever been on a terrace at that one point looked and been like, I wonder what that feels like.
Yeah. Just, it's, exactly. It's a very primal like, thing. Yeah, I would be the happiest person.
But yeah, just one.
The first time that I remember I had that thought was when I was 5 years old and my father didn't buy me a G.I. Joe. I was like, to fir kya point?
Was it like a good G.I. Joe?
It was like
Hey, they were all good G.I. Joes, hey, man. They're all good G.I. Joes. At five, they're all good G.I. Joes.
Yes. I need much standards.
So yes.
Joe bhi. But so I was committed, you know, suicide karna. But then.
This is the Bengali version of setting yourself on fire ke Shaktiman bachayega. Mujhe G.I. Joe nahi mila, suicide.
And wo bhi jata us din. But my mom came and said ke aaj cake bana hai.
You know what's amazing about that? If I was having a suicidal thought today and somebody called me and said, bro, cake hai. I would still be like, I guess postpone karna chahiye.
Which means you're still 5 years old. Cake, man. You know, this is what I've understood. Ke hum comics ka happy rehna thoda difficult isliye hai. Kyunki, as we know that negativity, as we discussed, is gold mine for comedy, right? Like people laugh when somebody slips on a banana peel. Not... Avoid करके चला गया तब कोई नहीं avoid करके अगर manhole में गिर गया very funny but वैसे otherwise not funny so negativity is very important for us right but what also we've learned is that if you're in a happy space then you work better so that's the conundrum we have कि we have to be negative on paper
sure
whereas positive in life
Yeah.
Which often is just, you know, it's just...
They cross over and then nothing happens.
I know you have some earlier bits where the sense we were talking about, the sense of... Chhodna. Like this underlying theme of... is prevalent in his bit. It's his style is very sort of low-key. You have that in certain bits. I definitely have that. You have that. I just want to talk about like, what do you think your existential bits are? And like how they came about?
मेरा तो एक ही टॉपिक है कि बच्चा नहीं करना तो उसी में मेरा उतना सारा जोक्स है कि आई एम ट्राइंग टू थिंक फॉर द लास्ट 5 years एक रीज़न मिल जाए बच्चा करने का और मेरे को नहीं मिल रहा है ठीक
है हाउ अबाउट बीवी को चाहिए आई थिंक दैट्स अ लेजिट रीज़न
भाई का ईगो भी तो है ना भाई भाई
को भी नहीं चाहिए तो फिर कॉम्प्रो करना पड़ता है ना
दिस फेस यू जस्ट डिड दिस इज अनिर्बान इमोजी
I'll explain you Anirban with one story. This is vintage Anirban. When we were struggling in Calcutta together, he used to often come in Bombay and try out, you know, stand up. And I'm at Kolkata struggling with the new guys. He would often call me and be like, share happy news, but with great sadness. Like he'll be like, bro, Veerdas just saw me. He said, I'm great, bro. Shit, bro. Shit. I'm like, what? Bro, I just got canvas, dude. They gave me headlining spot. Shit, yeah. Shit. Why? This is the theme of our relationship. Throughout, abhi aaj tak. Bro, Amazon called me. They want to buy my special, bro. Shit.
And no, I just like, tell him that whenever something good is happening, there's also some pressure. And I am immediately talking to him about, ki, okay, now this is my problem. I have to do this. Now you help me. Okay.
And I'm like, do you have any idea about my life?
मेरा लाइफ का सबसे बड़ा प्रॉब्लम एक्चुअली बच्चा नहीं है ये है ठीक है इसका लाइफ इतना फक्ट है एंड इसका लाइफ इतना फक्ट है मेरा नेबर है मेरा इतना पुराना दोस्त है एंड एवरी टाइम आई गो टू हिम विद अ प्रॉब्लम He is like इसी प्रॉब्लम का वर्स्ट वर्शन मेरे साथ हुआ है
यू आर लिटरली द लाइफ ऑफ ब्रायन
हाउ इज यू टेल मी हाउ इज फ्लायरिंग in Melbourne for the world's second largest comedy festival. A problem. When I am trying to convince local comics ki aaja hum log open mic karte. Audience nahi hai, koi baat nahi, tu mera joke sun, main tera joke sun. How is this a problem to me?
But is that a good reality check or does it like...
It is a good reality check because like then I am also nowadays thinking, is this a problem good enough to tell Sourav?
Yeah.
Or should I just like...
But your life is so fucked. You know who I really feel bad for? Whoever your reality yeah. check is. Whoever my wife.
Oh. So a lot of people have told me that, you know, randomly, I mean, that they want to make a documentary or whatever, you know, reasons are.
Yeah.
But more people have told me that I want to make a documentary on your wife.
Yes, that's more interesting.
Because right. how the fuck is...
what is she looking at every morning?
And I wanted to see, you know. Why, you know, sometimes I legit feel... that there's no reason for her to be with me, you know, because she's better at me with everything. Okay, she's better at work. She's a better looking person, conventionally and unconventionally. She's better at everything. Then why is she with me? I think she is an undercover agent who's using me as a cover. You know, someday like, there will be a crossfire and she'll use my child's body as a shield.
What do you think she?
Which is great that you have no trust issues in your relationship. I think that's the important
thing. So now see, now I can't talk to him about my relationship problems.
Yeah.
It's like my wife is a spy.
Maine abhi TCC pe dekha tu kar raha tha. Exploring this premise of I'm just figuring shit out.
Yeah.
And is like, what is that?
I have been, about that maybe. Bit basically that bit starts off, it's still very raw, but that bit starts off that I spent the entire last year figuring shit out and then I realized the year before that also I was doing that only, figuring shit out. The year before that, so I'm a professional figurer of shit, that's what I am. So I'm just like trying to see where this goes. But I like the this is the first time when I'm writing bits like these where I'm talking about क्या हो रहा है अभी लाइक जेन्युइनली फिगरिंग शिट आउट ऑन स्टेज आल्सो नॉट
राइट
आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट लाइक माय एज फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम आई हैव नेवर डन लाइक यू नो स्टैंड अप की ओके आई एम दिस एज
आई हैव सम टिप्स
या आई नो आई हैव सीन
गुड टिप्स टू गेट
आउट सो आई एम डूइंग दोस बिट्स फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम एंड आई एम लाइक आई जस्ट रियलाइज्ड आई वाज इन अ लिफ्ट एंड अलोन एंड आई जस्ट फाउंड मायसेल्फ टेलिंग मायसेल्फ oh man, alone. Okay. I was just in a lift. There's a mirror and I was like, oh man. And then I realized everything that I used to say during sex 10 years back, I say to myself like, oh my God, holy shit.
Yeh hai graph. Oh, amazing. No wonder we mind the shit. It's fucking
yeah,
funny.
It's hilarious.
Fucking funny.
That's hilarious.
So I'm like now trying to like, you know, explore that. Yeah.
That's hilarious.
Yeah. I've been there. Sometimes yeah. I sigh so loudly I scare my cats.
Yeah,
exactly. Like I'll just be sitting, it happens. Like I'll just be sitting alone in the room and suddenly on my phone and I'm like, wow, my existential is gonna creep my cats out.
Problem nahi bol sakta, but this is partly happening because of money and success.
Yeah.
Which is a very weird thing to complain about, but apne comedy scene mein dekhiya do.
Don't complain to me.
Mere paas nahi hai. Mere paas dono nahi
hai. So right now, I face this.
Mere paas dono nahi hai. Right now, as we speak, there are people writing on YouTube. Who the hell is Sourav Ghosh? It's just that you guys in the comedy scene think that, oh, we know this guy. He's been around.
Yeah, no, been around, we've been very good and all that.
Yeah.
But because there is that... अपना इंडिया में जो स्टैंड अप वेव हुआ सो मेनी पीपल गॉट सो मच सक्सेस व्हिच यू नॉट गॉटन सो क्विकली इन द वेस्ट एंड वंस दैट इज डन आपका स्पेशल आ गया आपके शोज आ गए आपका फैंडम बन गया आपका यूट्यूब चैनल बन गया ये हो गया लोग आपको सड़क पे जानते हैं ये वो अ लॉट ऑफ कॉमिक्स आर डन दैट एंड नाउ दे लाइक
Now what?
Yeah. Now what?
Yeah. Now
this
what?
This has not made me as happy as I thought it would.
Yeah.
That's such
while
a weird...
at the same time always walking around feeling like I have already achieved more with my life than I thought I would when I was in school
exactly.
or in college. So on the one hand, I'm like, there's always more to achieve. And on the other hand, I'm like,
both this is
what kiya?
Exactly.
What kiya?
So us time mein, like literally, mera inspiration abhi ye hai ki, chalo, maine fiction nahi likha, to mere wo karna hai. And dusra inspiration hai ki dekho bank balance zara acha nahi lag raha hai. So abhi no time for vacillation abhi.
Yeah, yeah.
Kaam karo.
The thing that really keeps me working is the fact that I've signed up for some 20-year LIC policies.
Yeah.
I'll need to keep paying for the next 20 years.
Yeah.
That's what really keeps me going.
I have also joined that club. I've like taken up some long term things and now I have
to
like
this is like talking to 300
I would like to point out though the cruel और मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि what can be more amazing slash depressing than the fact that the one thing that's keeping us all alive is our EMIs.
मेरे को यार मेरे को बैंड्रा में रहना है मेरे को सब जगह एसी चाहिए मेरे को पैसा
EMIs is nothing जब माँ के गहने गिर गए
there's nothing he went old school 70s
mother India and in Bengal so his actual mom could be Nirupa
clear first world problem.
Now you see.
It's so refreshing. I'm happier already.
It is. Yeah.
I feel like we've talked a lot about just existentialism, this, that. But at the end of the day, all of us fucking get up, keep going, do what's needed to be done.
Not him. He goes to sleep and then gets up. And then keep going.
But he gets up.
He gets up.
We whine about it. We put in our jokes. Whatever. But we do it. What do you have to do on a day that you can't do anything at all?
That depends. So for example, there are some days where if you can't do anything at all, you just have to admit to yourself that you can't do anything at all. But it's okay. Because also sometimes you fall into the trap of agar aaj main kuch nahi kiya toh matlab main waste hoon. Which is actually not how human beings, animals live in general. The other thing is though, but what happens if you had too many days of those in a row? Then I think part of it is just teaching yourself what they call mindfulness, right? That where you have to recognize a pattern of behavior and thoughts and almost give yourself a warning siren when, like my therapist way of putting it is, if you've been spending more than an hour just stuck in the same pattern of main useless who, etc., whatever, you need to train yourself to have a siren to go off in your head at that point and be like, I can't lose any more time to this thought process. And then go do whatever it takes to distract you. Whatever, but just get out of that thought process. And on a good day, you'll get out of it in 10 minutes. On a bad day, you won't get out of it. But have start building that mechanism. Some days, like I said, you just can't do it. Other days, just on a plain practical level, what helps you get, like you said, is bills hai bharne ka. Toh karna padta hai. And the fourth thing that I found really helps me is just trying to find a structure to hang things onto. Things that I'm forced to do. So today, something like, so for example, that sounds damn stupid, but just going to the gym 3 days a week.
Yeah.
Man, changes my brain chemistry straight up. Like in terms of from the endorphin etc. to the point where I feel extra low on the weeks that I end up skipping it, etc. So then that like a sort of magnet pulls you back to the good thing. So it's a combination of A, sometimes external pressure of just the fact that there's bills to pay and two, structure. So what do you
think? Oh, that's whining, burrowing in. Abhi workouts recently started over the last few months. Slowly. So that's addictive.
Also, friends. Not the show, the people.
Yeah.
Like, makes a huge difference. Just being able to have a few people around that you can.
Actually, going up on stage also helps me a lot.
Yeah.
When like I have nothing, like nothing is going right, and like not having a good day, not getting anything done. But just 5 minutes on stage, even with older stuff, just like getting on stage.
I sometimes find the problem with that to be is that the hardest thing to do is get yourself in a place to literally just get in a cab and go to that place where you can get on stage. That's when the battle is lost.
Yeah, for me, it's getting a train.
That's when the battle is lost, right? That's when the battle is lost entirely.
But basically, validation, you know, even if stage pe nahi bhi hua us din ya, matlab nahi Bombay mein nahi hua kahin pe, like kuch kaam aa raha hai ya afsos ka kuch kaam aa raha hai, things going wrong, then I realized ki one hack is if I write one good stand-up joke that day, which I'll not probably use for six months, but like, you know, I'll be excited ki okay, this is the time jo kabhi to kaam aayega, that like just changes my mood. Very quickly.
That's amazing.
That's not a hack. That's the goal.
Yeah, that's
a goal. Good stand-up bit. What?
Got it.
The hack is the solution.
Again, you don't have problems. How do you express these things as problems? So I'm seeing what you mean.
Dude, yeah, you see.
I'm starting to see your problem.
I just want to do a reality show where he just calls people.
I am not going home with you today. We'll live next to each other. You go alone.
I think you should have an agony uncle show on the radio where you just constantly tell people to shut the fuck up.
I just got out of radio.
I am telling you. He has problems for everything.
दस साल रेडियो किया मैं 10 साल See, I'll tell you why you should watch Afsos, because if you don't watch Afsos, then this fucker is going to call me and then cry how his 3 months have been gone, you know, sitting at an AC room in his own house at the 12th floor with a view of a swimming pool, okay?
Can I just say that the two of you are everything I ever imagined a Bengali lord in.
So cute.
I don't want to go through that shit.
I want you to watch Afsos so that Sourav Ghosh is finally successful. And then he understands my problem.
Mere level pe aa to bhai.
Shacks, why should people watch? Life is good.
Okay, so the whole point behind this show was A, to have fun for myself, mm-hmm. and B, for people when they come back home from a long day at work and they look at something on Prime and they look like,
yeah.
It should look like a fun thing to watch, and at the end of the special you should feel like you've had a good laugh, your time has been well spent, and yeah, you've just been entertained. That was the whole point. People should be able to come back and watch it and go, maza aaya.
I'm going to go to bed a little happier tonight.
That's a great name to click on. Life is good.
Haan, na?
Yeah.
And and then once you watch it, you realize usme meanings exactly kya. To meko naam acha laga. Mera option yahi tha ki when the thumbnail shows up, it should look like acha hai, fun hai. Because yaar, bahut stupid. We talked about death and existentialism.
Yeah.
I have fucking fart jokes and there's a segment called dumb thoughts, which is just chutia one-liners. And honestly, mere ko sabse zyada maza wo karne mein.
Oh.
Because it's just so dumb and you never get to be that stupid.
I can't wait for the sequel, Death is Bad.
Next special.